Here are the materials we will be using: a bucket, the watercolor paper, a polyester paper, the lithograph, a sponge, the water, the vinegar, and the pure cannoli, and the roller as well. Okay, to start the project, we're going to be using a 1:1 ratio of water and the apple vinegar. After putting that away, we're going to start mixing it in order for the water and the apple vinaigrette to mix in very well so the solution works for the paper. Okay, now we're going to grab our polyester paper that we are using that already has our printed image with it. And the image size is going to be 6.5 by 9, while the paper will be 11 by 8.5. As we slowly dip it in, we're also going to mix it in order for it to be fully complete wet from top to bottom and from the side to side. As you can see from our high point of view, we're going to mix it in. As you can see, we still have that small white spots that aren't going. That's why we're going to be moving it around for it to be fully completely wet. As we put the items on the side, we're going to start cleaning our small space for any ink or previous ink that has been used on the table. For the ink that I'm using, I'm using a Lisso black ink, and this is going to be the roller we're going to be using. As you can hear, the ink is pretty sticky, so we have to get it as soft as we can. And the video is going to be a bit quicker to show you how to do the process. We're going to go from front to back and side to side for the ink to spread evenly. And as you can hear right here, it is very smooth. It isn't sticky or anything. Now we're going to grab our paper that's been dipped into our solution for 3 minutes. And we're going to put it onto our space. We would also have a solution with Arabic gum and water. It's a 1:1 ratio with our sponge inside already soaking it in. And we're also going to pass it around our polyester paper for all the bubbles and for it to be spread so the solution doesn't come off. Okay, and now we're going to start inking. We're going to pass the roller once again, do the ink, and then once that's done, we're going to put it on our poly paper. Okay, as we start rolling, we go up and down as well, and side to side every once in a while when we see that the ink has been picked up. As you can see, sometimes the polyester paper might get stuck to the roller, so we would have to be very careful, but it is okay since it is very normal for that to happen. But either way, we can always put it down and go over it again. Now we're going to grab our watercolor paper. The watercolor paper surface has to be soft and smooth, and the watercolor paper also has to be around an 11 by 8.5. It doesn't come always like that. My paper is going to be 12 by 14 if I'm not mistaken, so we can always cut it down to the size that we would want to. On this time, I'm also going to be switching gloves as the previous one was always inked up with the black ink. And then we're going to pass our spray bottle around the paper and then smooth it out with a white cloth. And this will be the printer I will be using. It is a Conrad machine. You can also use other methods, such as using the car or the squeeze method. As you can see right now, I'm going to put the polyester paper down smoothly with trying to use not my fingertips as best as possible, and then putting on top the watercolor paper that's already been sprayed. I am also grabbing some butcher paper, brown butcher paper, that I can use on top of everything in order to keep it in place. And after that, we're going to be putting on mats in order to keep it leveled and surface to have nice pressure for the printer to press on. For this Conrad printer machine, we have to pull down the lever in order to give it the pressure. And for mine, I'm gonna try and smooth it out as it goes in so none of the wrinkles go up or any of the papers come down, in order for it, the surface to be leveled. And we're just gonna start rotating it to our direction. The process that I'm gonna be doing is gonna go over 4 times. So I'm gonna go rotating left to right, left, and then right again where I started. Once we are done printing, we're going to pull up the lever in order to release that force. And we're going to pick up the first mat, and then we're going to pick up the second one. As well as after that, we're going to pick up the parchment paper. And we're going to see that it is a very flat surface. As you can see on the corners, it did move a bit. So once it is picked up, you can see the sides where it needs to be cut off. So it's much more easier to know where it needs to be. See, for my image, some of them, they are smudged, very smudged, so we can always pass it with a white eraser to erase those images, but just very lightly from the surface. Now we're going to use a pencil. We can only use a pencil to write down the edition. This is a 6 out of 6 edition. The title is going to be in the middle. My title for this piece is going to be Forgotten Bliss, and the last part is going to be writing down your name. For cleaning it, for me it was very difficult, given that we're using pure canola, and we're going to use the butcher paper to clean everything up. The canola oil is very greasy, so that's why I sometimes wear gloves. As you can see from my left hand, it is very dirty from all the printing. That's why I mainly use my right hand to cover, since I feel like that's my main hand. And after that, we're just going to pour some bit, or a lot of it. It just depends on how much it is. You can see from that spot, it is very small, so we didn't need that many of cannoli. And while this pot actually did need a lot of cannoli and a lot of butcher paper, it took a while to get everything out, and then we also have to get the roller all over cannoli and just get it done. And lastly, these are the results I got from number 1 all the way to number 6. There are a few smudges here and there, but overall I feel like that is okay, since most of them came out really great. They're all some feel lighter and a few darker, but everything's all right. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!